Today, I'm going to show you exactly how you can earn thousands of dollars per month by creating online puzzle books. Now, I'm going to not only show you how to create those puzzle books step by step, but I'm also going to show you how to sell those books and how you can make a whole lot of money from them. But first, if you are new to my channel, I want to say welcome, welcome in. I'm so excited that you are here. Please do me a huge favor and go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. And make sure you turn on your notifications because I always have piping hot tea when it comes to securing the bag. And if you are returning back to my channel, then welcome back. We are all one big happy family. And I'm so excited to talk about this new side hustle because people are seriously making a lot of bank from this. Let's talk about it. So in order for us to make all of this money using these puzzle books, we have to have the right kind of software to do it. And your girl doesn't have a whole lot of free time. So I like quick and easy. And the way that you use the software to do it is through a company called BookBolt. So BookBolt is a software that basically makes it super easy for you to create low content journals, books, but in this case, we're going to be creating a low content item called the puzzle books, and it's actually going to put the book together for us. And when we're done creating the puzzle book, we're going to upload it to Amazon KDP. If you've previously tuned into my channel, you know that I've done a previous video on BookBolt where I created a composition journal and basically showed you how to go through that process and how to create journals in as quick as 5 minutes. So if you're interested, go and check out that video if you want to get a different spin on it before we get started with our puzzle book today. As I mentioned earlier, I was going to show you exactly how much people are making from these puzzle books. And the way that we do this is by installing something called KDP Spy. KDP Spy basically shows you this insider information about how much people are making, how many units they're selling per month. So after we go in and click on KDP Spy in BookBolt, it's going to take us to this page, which is basically a Chrome extension. Now, once you install this Chrome extension to your browser, it'll be super easy. So you won't have to keep logging into BookBolt to see this type of information. You'll basically be able to just click the little extension on your browser to get the information that we're about to look at now. So for purposes of this video, let's just type in Halloween word puzzles, right? So let's search for that. And then let's go over here and click on our Amazon KDP extension and let's hit start and let's see what it comes up with. All right, so let's look at the stuff related to Halloween. Here we go. Halloween word search for adults. This person has sold 6,000 units of this book in the past month. That is ridiculous. And if you look at the date, this is from August 28th. It hasn't even been a full month where this person has sold that many units and has made that much money off of one puzzle book. August 28th, they've sold $6,000 and they sold 891 units of a Halloween word search. So this is your proof that it's super easy to make thousands of dollars per month. And again, this book literally hasn't even been out for a full month yet. Okay, so in order for us to get started in BookBolt with creating our puzzles, we will want to navigate over here to where it says create. And then we're going to click on the option that says BookBolt Designer. We'll exit out of here. And if you are seeing this view, this is actually the classic view. This is not going to be the studio view that we're going to use to make our puzzles. So you'll want to make sure that you go up here on the right-hand corner and you click the option that says try the BookBolt Studio. That is the new studio and that's what we want to use. Okay, so this is the fun part. This is where we actually go step by step creating our word search puzzles. Now, I don't want to see all of this writing on here. That is just a little bit of a distraction to me. So what I want to do is I actually want to get rid of all of this writing on here. So I'm going to go up here to cover template and click hide KDP cover template to just get rid of that and hit okay. for, you can X out of it. What I've actually already done is I've looked for some Halloween images and I want to start creating my cover. So I went into, this is through Pixabay, which is, you know, the internally linked image database that is hosted on BookBolt. So I didn't have to pay for these images. Nobody had to create them for me. This is already in the image library. And we're going to want to make sure that we stretch this completely, because we don't want any white spaces on the actual books. Like when people start to purchase these books, we don't want them to see empty white spaces. So make sure that this is good and stretched. Okay, I think that looks good. Now I'm gonna add just a couple of things to this cover so that it's not just like, you know, an empty cover. So I'm just gonna type in Halloween, because this is gonna pretty much give me everything that I need. So there we are. We found the word Halloween. Now I'm just searching for like a really cute little image that'll kind of make this book cover pop just a little bit. So here are our friendly little bats. And I think this makes the cover just, it looks really cute. Like it's a friendly little cover, but it's also something that's like aesthetically pleasing enough for you to see it on Amazon and say, oh, that's really cute. I think I want to buy that. Now, I don't want to stop there. I'm going to add just one or two other things. I think I want to put like a pumpkin out here somewhere. Let me find a nice little picture of a pumpkin. Ooh, these are really nice pumpkins. And it actually has the word Halloween on it. And again, this is seasonal. So I want to make sure that, of course, this matches what I put in the description box for the actual puzzle book, but also make sure that it's easy for someone that's scrolling through Amazon to just say, oh, that's a Halloween type puzzle book. So I think that I'm going to add a little bit more. And so now that I've got my little label, this little white cloud, this is what I'm going to put my actual title of this word search book. So now that I've got that, let's go ahead and add a heading. Here we've got our heading. And I'm just going to name it simply put word search. It doesn't have to be complicated. And let me make this just a little bit tinier, so that it will fit in our cute little box. There we go. I think that looks nice enough. And I'm just gonna take some time to kind of tweak this and just make sure it's fully aligned. Okay, so now that we've got the cover, that front cover and that back cover done, let's go ahead and start working on the interior. So I clicked on page one over here to the left. And I'm going to click on where it says word puzzle. And I'm going to select the type of puzzle, which is going to be a word search. And I'm just going to do the first four pages. Now, of course, you can do a lot more pages. Most journals have at least like 50 pages in them. But for purposes of this video, I'm just going to do the first four pages. Click next. And here's my configuration. It allows me to determine how I want this to look. So I'm gonna do 10 words per page. That's how many words I wanna do in each puzzle. We're gonna add cells. Let's change the line color to black so it's easier to see. Very, very cool. And I'm gonna leave this color alone, but I am gonna go over here to using random words and sentences to fill that area, yes. And I do want to add solutions after the puzzle page. So we want to make sure all three of those boxes are clicked. Okay, so you may be saying, well, Jazzy, how in the world do we find that many words? You know, if you're doing 25 puzzles, 10 words each, that's 250 words. I can't think of that many. So all you do is go out to Google. You can type in Halloween words list. There are a ton of sites where you literally can grab words. This is the first thing that popped up. You could literally grab these words. I mean, it's not that complicated. If you want to click on here, this is teachstarter.com. Here's a bunch of words that you can do. And the list goes on. Like, there's just so many different ways that you can pull this information. Like, it's got Haunted House, Trick or Treat, Jack-O-Lantern, and it goes on. And this is just like some of the basic words. You can also click on adjectives, nouns, and phrases to see even more information around the different types of words that are related to that particular holiday. So let's get into this other part, which is how we actually generate those puzzles. So now remember, what we have to do is put them in a CSV file, which is going to be in Microsoft Excel. So here, I went ahead and took the liberty of basically pasting out some Halloween related words into an Excel sheet. Now, I only did it for the first few puzzles because you all get the drift, but what's important to note is for every 10 words that you do, let's say that you're doing 10 words per puzzle. Okay, you're going to do 10 words and paste them into this Excel sheet, and then you're going to do a space before your next set of 10 words. And you're going to put a space in between every set of 10 words. That's because you're using 10 words per page. Now, the space tells BookBolt when you upload the file, it's basically telling BookBolt that these are different puzzles. So if you put them all together, it's going to create one gigantic puzzle of 250 words versus if you do sets of 10 with spaces in between, it's going to recognize that every 10 words is a new puzzle. So once you've done that for however many puzzles you want to do, you're basically just going to go up here and click File, Save As, and you want to make sure that the extension on the end says .csv. So I'm going to change this to CSV up here, .csv, there we go. And I'm going to save it. And that's all we need to do for that. And then this is going to be the part where we upload the CSV file that we did earlier that has our actual words in here. Very simple. And let's hit submit. Give that a second to go. And here is our actual word search. So that was super easy, very simple. So I don't want it to exactly just look like this because this kind of looks plain. I want to tweak this just a hair. So what I'm going to do is actually highlight this. I'm going to bring this down. And then I'm going to add a nice little heading to this. Okay, perfecto, perfecto. And let's just call this like Halloween puzzle. Let's just call it number one. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. All right, and let's make that a little bit smaller just so you can see it. All right, cool. And I don't want it to be super plain. I'm just going to add me a quick little image in this. Just so that, you know, it doesn't look so generic. You know, let's do something theme-based. Let's do the pumpkin again. I'm not going to leave this huge pumpkin sitting right here. I'm actually going to change the opacity for this, which is going to kind of make it blend in a little bit. So let's take this down to about 20-something. And that way we can still see the letters very clearly. So now we've got our Halloween puzzle. So that looks super cute. Now we need to do the actual solutions. So let's do the solutions page. So if we just take a look at page 5, the letters that you see that are in black, those are our actual solutions. And the ones in gray are just like randomly generated letters. So we want to make sure that people know which solutions go to which puzzles. So I'm going to also give this a title. So I'm just going to move this down. That solution puzzle looks really, really good. I can see the words clearly and I can see the pumpkin in the background. So I think at this point we are ready to upload this to Amazon KDP. Now I've done the actual steps for uploading to Amazon KDP in a previous video. So you can check out that previous video, which I've linked down below. If you need all of the step-by-steps, what to do for Amazon KDP, but it only takes just a few minutes. So don't worry, it's not hard. So when it comes to marketing your particular puzzle books, You may be saying, well, Jazzy, how do people discover me? How in the world are they going to know that I have a Poseable that's available? So, of course, we've already talked about the Amazon KDP, and we've talked about using SEO and those keywords for people to be able to organically locate your content. And of course, it's going to be perfect when you're using those seasonal words that are related to different things like holidays and events that are happening. In addition to this, another way to boost your sales is going to be word of mouth. If you're putting together puzzle books for kids, this is something great for you to share with people that you know that are teachers, that maybe own, you know, daycares, that have any type of childcare learning centers. I mean, think about it. A teacher is going to have easily 30 students in each of her classes. Some of them have like 150 students, and they're looking for this type of stuff to keep their students busy in between different activities or when they're out and they have to get a substitute teacher. Now, that could easily be 150 sales for you just talking to one person. Imagine if you tell this to your church directors or other people that you work with on your job, people that like to host sleepovers, whether this is a fall harvest event that you might be hosting. There are so many different ways for you to sell this product in bulk. So make sure that you are also posting about this on your social media and you're telling the people that you actually know that you have a really super cool puzzle book or activity book to keep kids busy. So when it comes to using BookBolt, they have two different plans. Now, I want to emphasize, just so you know, if you're going to be creating these word puzzles, these activity puzzles, if you're going to do that, you're definitely going to want to use the Pro account. You have to have a Pro account in order to be able to use those features. Now, I do have down in the description box, there is a link that you can use to get 20% off using my actual link and putting in the actual code. So this would not be $19.99 per month. It'd be $15.99 per month to get all of those cool little tools that you use to create those activity puzzles. Now, if you just want to try before you actually do anything, before you commit to it, this is month to month. You can cancel at any time, but they do have the 3-day free trial just so you can kind of, you know, poke around, see what it's all about. And again, make sure that you have a Pro account if you're going to do the puzzle creation. So you just created your first puzzle activity book and you see how much earning potential there is. All you have to do is do a nice little cover, create a couple of puzzles, throw that thing on Amazon KDP and watch the money roll in. So please let me know how it goes. Let me know how your sales go. If you take the time to do anything like for Christmas or for Valentine's Day, I would love for you to drop a link down below once you get your stuff up and going, because I really love to see what you all are working on. Until the next time, I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.